Where the Chesapeake Bay meets the Atlantic Ocean, you'll find the vibrant and bustling coastal city of Virginia Beach. A popular destination known for its flourishing local dining scene and family-friendly attractions. It's also the home of Ellie Tran, a 35-year-old Vietnamese immigrant who lived with her parents and 2-year-old daughter Jolie. She worked as a manicurist and put in as many hours as possible to provide for her family. Ellie's parents didn't speak English but had flown in from Vietnam to help raise their granddaughter. They were a very close family and Ellie was happy to have them around. She was single but had previously been in a very rocky relationship with a 29-year-old man named Joseph Merlino III. Joseph was the owner of a mobile phone repair shop in Oceanfront, Virginia. The pair had met and fallen for each other right away. After several years of dating and moving in together, Ellie became pregnant. She was very excited and naturally told her family, who shared her joy. The plan was made for her parents to move into her place from Vietnam. It was important for Tran to involve them in the baby's life, and she told Joseph they would be moving in with them. He wasn't so happy about the idea. Once Jolie was born, Ellie tried hard to make everyone comfortable with the living arrangement. She had very traditional Vietnamese beliefs and wanted everyone to live together in the same home. Eventually, Tran became terrified of Joseph's controlling and abusive behavior. Ellie made a complaint to the police saying Joseph had grabbed her by the neck in front of their daughter and threatened to put her under the ground. Joseph was fined and she decided to end the relationship and move out. Ellie found a place for her and her family to live. She would go to work as the sole provider while her parents would watch Jolie. The situation worked for a while, and she was surrounded by love and support. However, Ellie and Joseph were engaged in a bitter custody battle. While Ellie was at work, Joseph occasionally tried to break into her home or follow her. Scared for her and her family's safety, Ellie had surveillance cameras installed in and around her house. She wrote in her diary that she was living in fear of what he might do. Joseph already had a new girlfriend, a woman he'd met in China while he was there for work. But without custody of his daughter, he refused to move on. On the evening of February 14th, 2017, Valentine's Day, at around 8 p.m., Ellie pulled into her driveway. She had no idea what was waiting for her. Joseph had been hiding off to the side and attacked her with an antique syringe as she got out of her car and headed to her front door. He plunged it into Ellie's upper leg and injected her with a dose of cyanide. Cyanide is a highly lethal poison that can result in immediate death in high enough doses. To put cyanide into perspective, a tiny fraction of a teaspoon can kill a human. Months before this attack happened, Ellie was in a traffic incident where a man, dressed in drag, got out of his car and threw a substance in her face. She went to the emergency room but was lucky and only had some slight hair damage. She had told friends later that it was Joseph dressed in drag. Unfortunately, this attack would end differently. Ellie's mother heard her screaming from inside the house. She rushed outside to see what was wrong and saw Tran sitting on the floor, holding her leg and pointing at a man running away from the house. "Merlino stuck something in my leg," she cried out. Ellie went inside her home to call 911 but passed out during the call. Her mom proceeded to finish the call despite having difficulty from the language barrier. The whole attack was caught on the surveillance cameras. The ambulance came and Ellie was rushed to Centaura Princess Anne Hospital but was declared brain dead by midnight. The following day, her family reluctantly turned off her life support. Ellie had died of cyanide poisoning. Joseph was quickly brought in for questioning. Ellie's mother had identified him, but it wasn't clear on the video whether it was him. Joseph said he had been over 100 miles away visiting family in Victoria, Virginia when Ellie had been injected. His cell phone put him at Ellie's house, but no calls or messages were sent from it, suggesting he might not have been with it at the time. After further investigation, Joseph began looking more and more guilty. He had a favorite local pizza place he would frequently visit, and one day they received a package addressed to Joseph. When the owner approached him about it, Joseph walked into the kitchen, grabbed the box, and left without saying a word. Police found a woman in New Hampshire who later testified that she sold Joseph a vintage steel syringe for $68 on the website Etsy. She said he used the pizza place's address as his shipping address. Officers also found internet searches about cyanide on Joseph's laptop and discovered he had a flight booked to China. He was charged with first-degree murder. While awaiting his trial, Joseph went on a 2-month hunger strike and lost 40 pounds. The prosecution believed he did this to make himself look different from the images on the surveillance video. He also sent coded letters to his family and girlfriend that were eventually decoded. Joseph was trying to get his girlfriend to create a false chat log to give him an alibi. He also wanted friends and family to say they saw him and her face chatting at the time of the murder. At his trial in June 2018, Joseph pleaded not guilty. His defense was still arguing that he was over 100 miles away at the time of the attack. Joseph would take the stand. He was questioned about searches made on his laptop in January 2017. Specifically, searches such as high-quality syringes, what if cyanide gets in the bloodstream, and how many milligrams of cyanide will kill you. Joseph said the MacBook computer in question belonged to his cell phone repair business and at least a half dozen people had access to it. He also testified that he had never heard of the Etsy website before it became an issue in his case. Joseph admitted to writing coded letters from jail to his mother and new girlfriend in China. He said he encrypted them because jail staff had repeatedly stolen his mail and failed to send it out, but he adamantly denied writing them to get the women to fabricate evidence for him. Merlino told jurors he was visiting his half-brother in Victoria, about 150 miles away and at least a 2.5-hour drive when the murder occurred. He said he had arrived 2 days before and was still there when police arrested him. Ellie's mother testified through a translator about the evening her daughter was attacked. She said she saw Joseph across the street and cried hysterically as footage of Ellie's ambush was played for the jury. Joseph Merlino was found guilty of first-degree murder and the jury recommended life in prison. He then ended his hunger strike. Ellie's sister, Phi Tran, had traveled from Vietnam to attend the trial and told the media that she was relieved at the verdict.
Thank you so much. I want to say my deeply appreciated from my family to the judge, to the prosecutor, attorneys, to the detective for their very hard-working, long-time day, and for the very, very great grand jury that helped us during the course. Yeah.
In December 2018, there was more drama to this case. At the sentencing, Joseph was wheeled into the court in an upright gurney-type wheelchair covered in a blanket. He was foaming at the mouth, rocking from side to side, and was unresponsive. The judge was forced to postpone the sentencing. A prison doctor testified that he could have been suffering from a mental condition brought on by the stress of being incarcerated. He also stated that Joseph started acting that way the morning of his sentencing. The prosecution said he was making it all up to avoid hearing his fate.
I did fake it, why wouldn't I fake it today? It doesn't make any sense. I'm hoping that this insidious justice that has been brought over these past 2 years won't fall into someone else's hands. And hopefully I can get some case laws out of it under my name.
The following week, Joseph was sentenced to life in prison.
Well, I do believe that this will be vacated and hopefully remanded for new trial.
Let me know your thoughts in the comments below.